Hey everyone, Joe here. Today I have a product I'd like to talk about. Now, originally I was just going to do an unboxing, but I thought, you know, I've been using this product for quite a while, so I think I can go ahead and do an actual review on it and give you a good honest review on the product. Now, what we have here is the Wasabi, you know, power, you know, batteries. These are camera batteries. Now, this particular one is for my 600D, which is the LPE8 battery. And like I said, I've been using these for quite a while, and I ordered some more, and I want to do an unboxing, but I thought, you know, I've been using them so long, I'll give you an honest review on it. So here we go. Now, let's first start by opening this, and I've already got the tape cut here. And this is how they come packaged. You know, got this, you know, fairly little cheap economical white box with sticker on top. First thing you'll find off to the side is your two, you know, LPE8 batteries, you know, in plastic. Then over here in bubble wrap, we'll find our charger, a car adapter in case you want to charge in your car, a European Asian style two-prong power adapter. This could be very useful when you travel. Trust me, I do. It is very useful. And we got our standard Wasabi, you know, charger here. Now this charger, these are like kind of universal. The trays actually come off, so that may be kind of an annoyance to you if you've never used them before. Since my 70Ds click on and slide off, it was an annoyance to me on my 70D, so I hot glued it, which worked fine. Now, here on these LPE8s, let me pull one of these out. Here's the battery. You know, these work pretty good. These just pop on and pop off. You know, no problem whatsoever. Like I said, if you don't have a problem with it, a little glue under the plate, that, you know, under here somewhere where it's not making contact, you know, solve your little problem. But other than that, most times it's not a problem at all. Okay, let's get this garbage out of the way here. Alright. Here we go. Like I said, you know, the batteries come little protectors here, you know, protect the terminals and stuff. Which on the LPE8, there's really nothing you can really damage it sticking out. These are kind of tucked away, but I guess it keep dust off of them. Now, the LPE8s that come with those Wasabis here are a 2,000 milliamp battery. So, you know, they have a little bit longer battery life than your factory batteries that come on the Canon cameras. Now, in actual usage, I say they last as long, maybe a couple photos longer. You know, they're not exactly, I guess they're advertising to be a much longer lifespan battery. But really, they work about as good as OEM. Now, I have had some batteries fail on me in the past, although those were Canon batteries, and you know, I never had any of these Wasabis actually fail on me. I have had some, you know, not charge as well to the potential. That was because I was using them on the Canon supplied charger. So that's why I'm going to recommend, if you do use these, use the Wasabi charger. The Wasabi charger actually charges a little faster, and I guess it charges them a little bit higher up, a little bit more juice into the battery, I guess is the best way to put it. So that way you can, these batteries, you know, keep performing as they was designed to. Now, let's see, got a little adapter here. Take it out, just slides on. As you can see, boom. I use this, it helps when you go to like Hong Kong or any other part of China, Taiwan. Although some countries will take a little bit different adapter. I know Hong Kong, they kind of got a mix of these. Of course, a tourist area, so it's really hard to find the regular style. Luckily, here in the Philippines, this is more common, although these are used to. So it's just whatever, you know, you need. Car charger, I don't know too many people that actually use this. But if you are in the U.S., you got a car, you travel, hey, at least you got it. It just simply just plugs into the back here, as you can see, and bam. You can charge your camera batteries in your car now. Can't beat that at all. And I hope everybody liked this review. I think they're pretty good batteries. I've been using them. I've had some batteries fail me in the past, but those were the Canon batteries for both my 70D and my 600D. My 600D battery actually completely quit working on me. A Canon battery just isn't a charge as well as it used to. It's gone on the downhill, but I still use it a little bit. But I've never had any of these Wasabi batteries actually give me any issues. Like I said, I thought they was not charging as well at one point, so I started using the Wasabi charger with them again, and it, you know, brought them back to life, and they worked much better. So if you do get these, use the Wasabi charger. Other than that, I really like these batteries. I plan on using them a lot more. Like I said, I use the ones with my 70D. Love them. I've had some for the 60D here, not 60, 600D, and I love them. The reason I bought more was because I used the 600D for time-lapse and stuff, and I need another spare set for, you know, my battery grip. Just easily switch them out, keep taking photos. And like I said, these come with a charger, an adapter, car adapter, European Asian adapter, you know, two batteries for like $25 to $30 off Amazon plus tax. You really cannot beat the price. I think they're great. I plan on using them for most any camera. Now, there are people who do have horror stories saying you should not use aftermarket batteries. They could explode. These are premium cells from Japan, but I will point out they do say made in China on the back. So I have mixed thoughts on that, but like I said, I've never had any problem with them. Now, as far as using the batteries and stuff, like I said, I feel very confident using it. When I first started using them a couple years ago, I was like kind of skeptic. You know, Canon does charge a lot for their accessories, and the batteries at $60 a pop, you know, if I get two batteries for less than $30, you know, as long as my camera don't catch on fire, I don't care. I will have to point out, a lot of people say don't mix batteries, and I'll also agree to that. You should never mix batteries. However, if you're using Canon battery grips, Canons do not use both batteries at the same time. It will switch to one battery to the other. I think it's whichever one's got the most power when you cut it on. It just defaults over to. Nikon, however, will combine both battery cells together. That also helps to get a higher performance in shooting. So I do not recommend mixing these on a Nikon whatsoever, because you should never mix any battery. Doesn't matter if it's in a camera, remote control car, you know, quadcopter. Never mix batteries whatsoever. Heck, don't ever mix them in your TV remote. This is bad news. It causes them to explode and stuff. So that, keep that in mind. Like I said, I like these, use them. And I hope everybody likes this review, finds it informative. Ain't a lot to say about the batteries. I just like them. They work well, hadn't had any fail. If you like this review, hit the like button down the bottom. If you haven't subscribed yet, you know, please take the time to subscribe. It's free, it's for you. Let you know when I release more videos. Until next time, everyone, thank you for watching.